shot him with a Grim Reaper. It did a nice number on him. But we got two big fat hind legs and some perfect loins for tonight's dinner. You're watching Relentless Pursuit, and we're slocking stuff out here in the desert. A jackrabbit is probably one of the most underrated wild game meats on the planet. Let me tell you why. They're just dang delicious. And you can see I'm skinning the fur off of him here. He's a good sized rabbit, and they have a lot of meat on them, and believe it or not, that meat is just absolutely delicious. I like it better than whitetail, actually. Let me show you the size of a loin on a jackrabbit. I just tipped my guide, who just left because he's going to a predator calling contest of all things, left us here, and I tipped him with a cold steel knife. He was pretty thrilled about that, but anyhow, I'm using the kitchen knife, and that's a big piece of meat for a rabbit. And these legs, look at the hams on these legs. Okay, so I'm going to dress the rabbit now, and we're gonna take it in the house and fry some up. Okay, so now we're in the kitchen, and I'm gonna add a little vegetable oil, because that's all I've got here at the lodge, but normally I cook with olive oil when I'm doing my rabbit. Okay, I've taken all the little chunks out of the rabbit. I've got both his loins and the main ham off of the back legs. Whenever you're cooking tough game, no matter what it is, even if it's a buck and you want to eat it, you know, fry it and eat it quick, you want to make small cuts of meat and don't overcook it. Same with the rabbit. I added some Japanese breadcrumbs, which I add those in with my flour, about 50-50, all right? And then instead of seasoning your flour mix, just season your meat and with whatever you like. And I like a little bit of garlic, a little bit of salt, a little bit of pepper, and that's about it. So that's the next stage of what we're gonna do with this jackrabbit. Okay, so I've mixed my breadcrumbs with my flour and the meat, and you get these little pieces here, look just like that. Now what you want to do is make sure, which I didn't show you, but you want to make sure the meat is wet before you put it into the breadcrumb mix, and then just drop it in this hot grease. We're going to let this fry for a couple minutes and then turn it over, and we'll show you what a delightful little meal we've made out of a jackrabbit. And you can cook your gray fox the same way. Armadillo the same way. Just about, you know, a lot of your wild game meats. Squirrel, same way. Turns out perfect. Just remember, big pieces don't work so well with tough wild game. Keep it small and cook it quickly and get it browned on both sides, and then take it out of the grease. Took me about a whopping 10 minutes to make. Between dressing the rabbit, cutting it up little pieces, flouring it with my bread crumbs and flour, put it in some hot grease, and what most people would consider as a rodent that isn't edible is now something just as delicious as it could be. But prove a good point to you here. Carrie! Come here, honey. We're gonna test this out on my beautiful wife, Carrie Wells, because she doesn't eat most anything. Come here, babe. She don't like anything, so try the jackrabbit, honey.
I'm eating the chocolate chip cookie.
When you're done eating that chocolate chip cookie, give it a try.
Mmm.
Ah. We're gonna try some possum next, see how she does. Sometimes, don't go with what everyone else tells you, because not everything is yucky. Some of this wild game is the best stuff on the planet. Possum, coon, jackrabbit, gator gar, we eat it all. Fox is next.